about Photo Prem which made you come on board?
I think the story, and it's such a unique subject and such a unique thought. And I just said yes to it in a jiffy. I didn't even think, because it would have been stupid of me to say no to such a film. Very interesting. I've never done such a character. And you know, after playing multiple characters through all my life, not that she looks different from the other characters that I've played necessarily, but her thought process was something which was so unique. And it was challenging at certain stages, because as an actress, I'm used to the camera, and I had to work on that fact that, you know, this lady is uncomfortable in front of the camera. So these are little challenges that make an actor really get interested in the part. And that's why I just said yes to it. And I'm glad.
Aditya and Gayatri, like, how did you guys come up with this thought of Photo Prem? Like, how did the story came to you?
I met this female. She's a 55-year-old female. She was at this couple of years back. And she had gone to a photo studio. She had got dressed up, makeup, and put on all the best she could. And she had gone to a photo studio and clicked herself. And she was showing those pictures to all of us. And I asked her what, like, why did you go to photo studio? You spend money, when you literally spend money and go to photos. Then she said, I don't have a good picture, so I clicked. So there was another thought in my mind, is like, I used to always see those pictures put on the wall after people have gone, and they are of old people. They look old in those pictures, with white hair, no teeth, and you know, people, we spend like 60, 70 years of our life, and our, the picture that is there, it's just, it's not who we are. Was used to always bother me. So when this happened, I thought, I connected those dots, and I thought this will make us something very interesting to watch. And we wanted to do a death film that is not very serious and it's not very intense. It has to be fun. You can't do anything about death. It's going to happen. But this, so we wanted to treat it.
So ultimately, we realized that photo is the only thing that you're going to be leaving behind. And if you leave those frail photos behind you, it's not going to be good. So that's how it started.
So from the trailer, Photo Prem, it to me seems a very hilarious take on death as well. And somewhere it raises a poignant point about women's identity somewhere also. So what are the themes which you guys have explored in the movie?
The other thing, you know, in this world of Facebook and TikTok and all these things, we are so influenced by other people's pictures that, you know, you just want to show up. So you borrow somebody's goggle, you'll borrow somebody's jacket and get yourself clicked. But inherently, that is not who you are, right?
Right.
That was an idea of, you know, trying to get a picture where you be yourself, be natural. Why be scared about it? Why should we have an inferiority complex of being the way we are? So
right.
that is one of the ideas that we explore in this, of being truthful to the picture. When you look at the picture, you should feel like this is my picture and not that, you know, kisi aur ka hai.
What do you think about this today's generation's photo culture? They're obsessed with this selfie culture, and like, they live their lives more in the pictures than they do in the real life. What do you think about that?
Well, I am also part of it. I go with the flow. But yeah, sometimes think that, you know, instead of enjoying a view, the first thing one does is, you know, reach out for the camera and want to click it because they want to share it. Yes. It's about sharing. That's what gets a little disturbing. But, you know, each generation has their little idiosyncrasies. I'm sure my generation, my parents, myself, what are they doing with themselves? So that way, I guess the children also have their thing. But yeah. They do, because it's available. Technology has become a very, very important part. And now in COVID times, we really realize how technology has really helped us, you know, communicate with each other.
Mehul sir, how much do you think that a film like Photo Prem is necessary at this point, especially when people are looking for some light content? Given that we have been watching a lot of crime thrillers and all those Mardhad wala shows a lot, so how much do you think that Photo Prem is important at this point, especially?
Yeah, I mean, it's obvious, isn't it? I mean, you all watch all intense kind of shows in multiple languages, from all over the world, and then something like this. I mean, I would like to think that this will come like a breath of fresh air with a very, very beautiful story that anybody and everybody can resonate to, can connect with beautiful, beautiful acting, a light, flavorful story with messaging, fantastic music. I'm sure Kaushal is here. He's responsible for the music. He will speak more about the music that we have put in. So I think something, so it's like you've been watching colors and colors and colors, and suddenly something that is just black and white will, you know, make you want to stop in your tracks, or you know, it attracts, it screams for attention. That's what I am hoping this film does, in all the intense or all the fast paced content that is available. Our film will bring a nice you know, nice flavor, nice soft, easy, wonderful feeling, and it will ask some questions, some pertinent questions.
This is my question to everybody. Like, the Marathi cinema has been telling like really good stories despite a budget constraint, but still they don't get as much viewers as they deserve. Where do you think that this is lacking behind?
I think Kaushal will be able to give us a very good perspective.
I also thought that.
See, creativity needs no budget. So that, apart from that, you know, when we think of something, we really don't. This is a $1 million story, I feel. For example, this film should be watched by, see, India's population is big enough to accommodate everything, actually. So let's not think about this film as a Marathi film for Marathi audience. It's a universal film in the in Marathi language, that's all. But it, anybody will identify. You know, people from Uttar Pradesh or Tamil Nadu or Kerala or Rajasthan, they will be able to identify with Mai, and I can say this with 100% guarantee, because the more regional you get, the more universal you become, actually.
No, I also need to say about Marathi film. You know what? I mean, at least I'm a Marathi film actress who works in Hindi and in English and in French and all over. But you know, like, we are very open to watching South Indian movies with subtitles.
Right.
But the moment my Marathi, at least my people, I mean, my friend might be taking me for granted, but is it good to have subtitles? Why you watch a Tamil film, you don't understand a damn thing about it, but you do watch it. Because they have reached that platform, as Kaushal said. We need to cultivate that, you know, more. I don't know, but I think with Photo Frame, it will break the barriers, which it already has, in a way.